So, and Ballyrath is the early back marker. So, having taken the first two, everything...
So, to be a successful trader, you've got to be protecting your bank all the time. I can see this runner's coming in a bit. I'm watching the favourite. Is that money safe? I'm not so sure. I'll take it out. See how quickly I took that out? I use the X key. As soon as I set it, I press the button. It's much quicker than using the mouse, so I recommend you use hotkeys. You can see it's coming to favouritism now. The ladders are switched round. So it was the wise thing to do, because we wouldn't want to be stuck at a loss if we don't need to.
Doggly, doggly!
So, and you can see that there's gaps in the market. We've got to be patient. Patience is a virtue in this game. If you can't be patient, if you overstake, whatever, you're going to lose money, quite simply. You have to be very patient, wait for the opportunity. If there's none in this race, then we simply won't trade. It's better to not trade than risk a dodgy situation. Let's get the sound on till we get the money. It's quite a long race. It's a 3 mile, 5 furlong race. So you can see it's going to last roughly 8 minutes. Ground's probably a bit quicker, so it might be a little bit quicker than that. We've had nice weather recently, but we'll see. And we won't be putting money through unless we think it's really safe and we can get it matched both sides of the book quick. And you can see at the moment, if you look at this, that the markets aren't bouncing that much. So if I was to go net 310, for example, and then with a full tick offset, I'm up here. Look how long it would take for my money to get matched. The longer it takes, the more dangerous it is what you've got to consider. So we're watching the race timer constantly, and we are just waiting for something that we see is safe. Nice little bit of market bounce, ideally with a nice little money beneath us, so if we get it wrong, we can get out against that money. Just keep it as safe as possible.
Outside, Cuda Panso in a close enough fourth, and ridden along in fifth is Ballyrath as they get over the next. Still a long way to go. This is fence number 8.
Flying, I'm popping in there because there's some big money beneath me.
Rosa. Ballyrath's getting more detached in rear. He's 10 lengths behind the other four now and getting a couple of reminders.
We're not being greedy. We're only going for 4 ticks at the moment. We may be able to get more ticks later. Now you can see there's an empty slot beneath me, more or less, so we might as well take that.
And then Via Dolorosa's been a busy boy, had 3 runs in April.
We don't want the market to creep down to us. We want it to bounce as well.
About 3.65. And this month he's finished second at, you know, at Market Raisin.
Patience. It's all about patience.
Back to March, he won a couple, Sutherland Fakenham. And he's close up here behind Flying Verse. Jerry's back the outside. And then on the inner is Cuda Panso. And Ballyrath, having been ridden along to do so, has got
a bit lower that down a tick again because it lowers my liability.
The Worsley continues to
200
be
there is obviously holding things up.
Once again,
so
having
we'll
jumped
just wait.
Of the 20.
I'm going to reset my ladders, so this might move to a different ladder now. Yeah, it's over here now, you see.
Was second, albeit quite a long way behind the winner at Newton Abbott last week, and is in front.
Now I'm protecting the bank. I took that out straight away, and the reason I did that is because that 200 disappeared beneath me. I wasn't sure if the price was going to come in or not. It didn't, but you know, you've got to protect your money all the time.
Come over the next circuit. Flying Verse, Jerry's back. Via Dolorosa, little gap to Cuda Panso, and a bigger one to Ballyrath. So in another circuit, this will be the last, and it is Flying Verse that has the lead.
So we've got a long way to go, bear in mind, so I feel quite safe with this. We should get matched. And if not, we'll just lower the price.
Jerry's back.
But all been too long. And the rest.
Trainer Ben Haslam.
And the rest. And the rest. Come on.
And they're a long way clear of Ballyrath, who's still
going to lower that last £3. I'm not going to mess around because we want to just have our profit in and out. It's as simple as you don't mess around.
The champion jockey leads on Flying Verse.
Probably a bit greedy going for 8-6. If I'd got 6, I'd have probably been matched a lot quicker.
Exit to the village for the last time in this veterans race, and still Flying Verse.
I'm watching the race timer constantly.
Setting his own pace. Looks very much like Ballyrath's going to be pulled up as they head now towards fence number 16. Got 6 left to jump. Everything once more. And coming towards the first.
Everything once more, as you can hear.
Jerry's back, Via Dolorosa. Flying Verse. Good jump, Jerry's back. Via Dolorosa. Cuda Panso 4 lengths off them.
And we don't want to be too greedy and being too late. Don't forget, we're watching that race timer and we are going to run out of time soon.
It's then 4 lengths to.
So we need our exit out pretty quick.
Pulled up before the 15th.
Come on.
And now heading towards the wood side for the final time here. And it
come out of here, man. The leader.
So we are running out of time. We're going to have to protect our bank zone. If we're not matched, we are matched.
A couple of lengths.
And that is job done. We're not going to trade at the end of the race, the dangerous bit. So we're coming into my warning, which tells me to close off trades, and then we're coming into that red zone, which is the dangerous bit. So that's £5.85 off a £50 bankroll. Not bad going. That's 10% in one day.
Sucker.
But you've got to constantly be protecting your money, constantly protecting your bank. You know, so you wouldn't want to be involved now because the horse may go on to win, it may not, I don't know. You know, I have no clue. So don't get involved in this bit. Move on. Next race.
Carla Martin in front from ever so saucy Lady La Rome. Parked out wide, Story Rory with Forever and Fire.
Not even halfway through this race yet, bear in mind.
Story Rory.
Early days, it's a dangerous race, but we're going to have to get this money out soon, for granted. Don't be in the
five left to jump.
Carla Martina,
the leader from ever so saucy Lady La Rome.
I'm pretty confident.
Story Rory, Forever and Fire and Cottage Artist, and then Buto.
Go on, we're one tick away.
Next, and then Joyful Noise, Force of Forces, Lenabo Bridge, who made a mistake.
That's all we make.
Off the bend. Coming up to past the stands the second time. As they head on inside the halfway stage, Carla Martina with the slender advantage over ever so saucy Lady La Rome. Story Rory, the near side of Forever on Fire, and then Cottage Artist and Meow Sagosha. And Buto, two in front of Force of Forces and Rocco Reenock and Joyful Noise, and then Balgala, the Mighty Molly, Lenabo Bridge has been shuffled right back to the rear of the field as one behind Lord M.
I'm out of here, man.
Embarking on their final circuit. Three flights left to jump. Carla Martina up there in front from Flag Fall leads ever so saucy, Forever and Fire's improved, then Lady La Rome, and Story Rory, and then Cottage Artist and Buto. Rocco Reenock next with Force of Forces bumped along. Meow Sagosha followed by Joyful Noise, Balgara, the Mighty Molly. Discount Glenabo Bridge and Lord M. Climbing to the third last flight. Up to the mound they go. Carla Martin.
I'm out of here, man.
Has made virtually all of the running. Story Rory has picked up the chase, then Lady La Rome and Buto. Forever and Fire, ever so sorty, is starting to feel the pinch. On the inside, Rocco Reenock with Force of Forces and Balgala, the Mighty Molly, Joyful Noise, and probably the world's greatest artist. 5 furlongs to go. They're heading for the second last flight. Carla Martina. Hasn't
too long.
Has
to get it out. Protect the bank. Always protect the bank. Move on. It's a dodgy race. It's only 141, but it's a safe 141, and we can always move on and make money in the next race. Granted, look, you see it flying around, but it's just too dangerous now. If that horse was to hit the front and go on to win, then you could leave yourself in a lot of trouble. And look, it's certainly doing well. The price is coming in. It's up there against the rail. Look. Whether it wins it or not, I don't know. But you know, it's dangerous. There it is, look. So it doesn't look like it is going to win, but I want to know that. Well, it still might do, actually. Who knows? But you've got to be really careful and protect your bank, especially in these more dangerous races. I mean, they're dangerous to trade in the first place. Unless you're a pro, I wouldn't even consider it. But you see how early I've got out. Only taken £1.41. Could have made more money, but it was dangerous money. And you've got to always make sure that the reward is worth more than the risk.
A length and a half to Sicily. Gliding Bay, the white cap in third. And then La Belle V, King of the Kippax, weighted with in the Midland Park silks of light blue. And Rushford and Luke Morris continue at the back end of the field. Into the loop they go. Dougie Costello glancing across aboard the pace-setting grey cowboy. Gliding Bay moving back around the outer of Sicily in the dark jacket. King of the Kippax in the slipstream of the leading half of the field, just in advance of La Belle V in the red and white, and Rushford continues to be weighted with a patient ride at the back of the field.
So Hadir!
Through the halfway point, and Cowboy steadying it down on the apex of the bend. Gliding Bay back at his quarters, Sicily the rail. King of the Kippax, James Doll, the light blue silks in fourth place, within 3 lengths of the lead. And then La Belle V and Rushford Maroon Jacket continues in rear. They've less than 5 furlongs to travel now. And in line for the final half mile.
The grey head. I'm out of here, man.
Just about in front, a Gliding Bay on the right, King of the Kippax moving menacingly in behind Pearl Blue Jacket. Sicily chased along, needs a bit of daylight, Dark Silks, Rushford and La Belvie in rear, and the tempo begins to lift, a steady pace unwinding inside the three.
I'm out of here, man.
In front, Gliding Bay ridden, still Sicily looking for an out, the brown cap, King of the Kippax on the right, produced now to challenge Dahl.
Sucker.
Following him through, then La Belvie in the red and white ridden, furlong and a half to go, and King of the Kippax has moved through to challenge Cowboy, Gliding Bay, Sicily trying to thread the eye.
Get your air, protect the bank. Somehow he wins now, does it? As long as you're safe.
Yards to cover. King of the
he's going to win there.
Rushford now charging down the outer. These two moving on together. Rushford coming to King of the Kippax. And
that's why you see I lowered that exit. I didn't take the risk.
Market
I lowered
suspended.
Because I could see it was getting dangerous. I'm protecting my bank the whole time. I only made £3.15, but you know, I'd rather have £3.15 than have a £50 loss. So just bear that in mind. Protect your bank at all times. So this is on the shorter end of the distances I like to trade. It's only 1 mile, 4 furlongs. It's maidens. If you look at the race, you can see there's only really sort of four runners, say, that are any decent. You've got one sort of outsider, then you've got a load that are just kind of like massive outsiders that probably won't play much of a part. So obviously if one of these two favourites cocks up, it's going to affect the other price. We need to let them get in, but because it is short like this, we really need to be getting out earlier. Whether it's for a profit or a loss, we need to be closing off pretty damn quickly. Not be greedy. Don't try and push an extra trade through. Just try and get a little bit of money through. See what happens.
Market in play.
Striding away, perfect alibi. Swift into stride. The royal run.
So just waiting for the stars, and they are the forces to settle down a little bit.
And Buick in no hurry, and she drops right to the rear of the field early on, just briefly chasing.
And if we can't get a trade through, we don't get a trade through. You know, some you have to learn to sit on your hands.
Doggly, doggly.
Yellow colours. Wider out is Zyra's Lioness in the black jacket, with then Saint Colette the grey. Behind these towards the inside, Wonderful Times.
So I'm watching both runners.
Graf is just steadied towards the rear. Maridardi is towards the back, and Eternal Pearl is still held up at the rear of the field, but just on the inside has made a little bit of progress now to come and
for the moment. Now the market's a bit more buttoned up, so I'm just going to cancel that off for a minute.
For Tom Marquand, who shows the way, they prepare to leave the back straight, and they're entering the final mile. In second is River of Stars, third for Candy Shack on the inside of Zyra's Lioness. Fifth place for Wonderful Times, just ahead of Graf in the green, white,
not
and
quite
pink.
Moving quick enough.
Next. Eternal Pearl,
like
still towards the back of the
yet.
Field, sharing last place with Maridardi. And between that pair,
doesn't
is
mean
Tom
they won.
So now they turn down the side of the racecourse, and we're heading towards the halfway stage. Perfect Alibi has led them every step of the way and still travels strongly, with River of Stars about a neck away in second.
Got to be careful with these front runners as well.
Third is Candy Shack. In fourth place is Zyra's Lioness. Fifth for Wonderful Times is
Putting
with Saint Colette. And Graf, still towards the back and rather hemmed in at the moment, is Eternal Pearl in the blue jacket, racing on the inside of Tunqua Lake. And Maridardi as they're passing the 5 furlong pole. Perfect Alibi has turned for home and has the advantage by a length or so from River of Stars and Candy Shack. Wonderful Times has made ground into fourth place. Now plenty of room
now
for
we can just close that
to
off.
At this stage towards the inside.
Blue we have actually got time for one more.
Mile. Zyra's Lioness is pushed along, then Graf St. Colette, Maridardi on the extreme left-hand side as William Buick just looks to change course, but his mount just hanging
I'm out of here, man.
Pearl. 3 furlongs to go. Perfect.
Okay, and that's it.
The front end, pressed by River of Stars.
That's it. Now I'm out. I'm not risking my money. You know, this is a shorter race, it's more dangerous, so we've made £3.34, I'm happy with that. Granted, the horse doesn't look like it's going to win, but, well, you never know.
I'm out of here,
know.
Man.
But going in now is just a lottery, whether it wins or not, and if it does, you're going to get absolutely stuffed. So you definitely don't want to be in a trade in this long, and it might actually win, look, it's close, is it going to? It's going to be a close one, I'm just going to sound in case it's
okay,
a photo.
Perfect Alibi, they hit the line together. Perfect.
Market suspended.
Stars, the only two that were ever in it. Judge needed to confirm. Eternal Pearl hung a chance away in third and then in fourth.
I know who won that.
Candy Shack.
Yeah, it won it.
Well, a terrific race here at Newbury Far Side.
So, you see, that did come back and win it. And it's not worth having money in the race. The race could have run slightly different. It could have got a bit more ahead and we could have got in trouble, by having high... liability in there, and we don't want that. We need to get closed off before
market suspended,
before the race gets dangerous. And if that means taking a loss or taking a scratch, whatever, you have to do it. You have to do it. But you see, that was a pretty easy £3.34 because I've picked the right race. You can look at the time, look up here. It is 22.3. It's the first race I've even traded today. And I've waited for this one. And then I've only traded for a small section of time to make my £3.31. If I only trade 3 or 4 races today and only make a tenner today, then so be it. It's better that than losing money. Best of luck in the markets. So, sitting on your hands. So I'm sitting on my hands. I've got to wait 22 minutes until the next race I can trade, because the races in the meantime just do not suit me in terms of distance. Sitting on your hands and not trading, not entering a market that doesn't suit your strategy, it's one of the most important things you can learn when you're trading Betfair. So have a shorter race here. Got to be extremely careful. In and out very quickly. We don't want to risk our bank.
Market in play.
We've got to make sure liquidity is okay. It was all right pre-race. Let's get on and do it and make sure we're in and out quickly, even if that means for a loss. We really want to be out not too far after the halfway stage.
Doggly.
Round about there, I suppose, roughly. But certainly don't want to be involved up here at Bristol side.
Who has won at Leicester previously back in June of last year. It's been given time to catch the others, can be slowly away. So that's not uncommon for him as they continue to climb down the back straight and about to take a right-handed turn. So Carragillahy has the advantage by a length to in second place Dual Identity. Tucson Cloud comes next for Ryan Moore with the white
cap. It's a game of patience, looking for an opportunity. We don't get an opportunity, we don't trade.
A five-timer today.
You're not just chuck the right money in and hope for the best. See, this market's no good to me because all this money is pushing in.
Start to freewheel down the hill, heading towards the final 5 furlongs of the contest. Still leading is Carragillahy from in second place Dual Identity and Jim Crowley. Couple of lengths back to Tucson Cloud. Pushed along is Denby in fourth place. Then comes Croeso Cumrai at the back, who's still going well enough as they head
down
the
straight.
We want
that money out.
Just over
not
half
a big
mile
profit,
left to
I realise.
In the Leicester Students' Handicap. Carragillahy has the advantage still from Dual Identity. He's only a length down. Ridden along now, Tucson Cloud in third place. Then in behind Croeso Cumrai. And they've
dropped
that
money
Denby,
out.
Who's well beaten off inside the three. Still Carragillahy
now going
pretty
man.
Well, though. Dual Identity is now moving up size. Tucson Cloud continues to be ridden along, as does Croeso Cumrai.
See if I can get a little bit more out of it.
Taking over Dual Identity inside the two. Dual Identity going on.
And that's it. You see, like, we're out nice and early. We've protected our bank. This horse could go on and win it. It may not win it. Who knows? Until we see it in a second. But
sucker.
Looks like it is going to win it. So you can see, again, I would be in trouble if I had not traded that at the right times. It's going to go on and win that. So we've basically made money by it laying the winner. But we've done it by doing it in the safe time frame. If you're involved late in that
market
race...
Market suspended.
When they go for the finish line, you're going to lose a lot of money. Don't do it.
Intent on restraint, trying to anchor the horse. Another one's moving forward is Rival in the stripe colours. But the early pace is not strong. They're well...
So we have a short race here. There's quite a few runners in it that have got a chance,
doggly.
Which may mean liquidity is low. And if we look into these bars up here, you can see there's not that 852 and that 1,000 sort of dwarf the other bets, unfortunately. So when they're off, we'll be able to see actually what things are looking like. So you can see there's a few gaps. The market is moving around, so we could get a trade through. But because it is a short race, we need to be out well early. And protect the bank. Whether that is for a loss or a profit, it doesn't matter. We have to be out early, because if we don't and we accidentally lay the winner, we're going to be in a lot of trouble if we haven't closed that position off. So let's see what we can do.
Inside the final mile. In second place, the free-sweating Rival on the outside of Merlin's Beard, and then Trinity Girl and Tregley. And the pace has picked up.
Markets were moving, but they're buttoned up a little bit at the moment.
Glory with Nelly Moon next, then
like I say, you don't have to put a trade through on a race. You don't have to. Court. And in fact, you shouldn't be if you don't think things are suiting well. So I'm still looking up here. Look, you can see there are a couple of little gaps, but mainly there is money flowing both sides of the market. I'm not going to be going in for too big a stake on this, so hopefully our exit should get matched. We don't want it to take 6 attempts to get off. Our exit matched at whatever price.
That's the orange colours on that one's outside. On the right track, the grey, Abrage and Eagle Glory is last of all. So Grand Scheme it is, who turns for home with the advantage half a mile to travel. In second is Rival, Merlin's Beard is third. Trinity Girl, Tregony still...
So I'm watching that race,
half a mile to go, just angled out one off the fence. Then behind these on the outside comes Glide Down. Wise Glory, Scampi amongst horses, is making good ground.
I'm out of here, man.
Through the field, Caramelized on the outside, has a clearer...
If we're not matched soon, we're going to have to close this off.
There is Scampi, preserved the run. Out in the lead, it is still... out in front, Grand Ski, Merlin's Beard travelling strongly in second. Tregony.
And that's it. I didn't get matched. I'm not going to risk my money now. And
if you're
if you're scalping and putting trades through now, then it's suicidal because, you know, you've got pretty much two horses to pick from.
Sucker.
Probably three when I first said, but one of them is going to win. So and they're going for the line. And either of these two could still win. Looks like Grand Scheme's won it, but you never know. Do you know what I mean? With horse racing, you never know. So protect the bank.
Market
if it means not
suspended.
Putting money through, don't put any money through. Wait for the next race. Always wait. Be patient. Be patient.
Turn already.
So protecting the bank, got to be really careful. We don't want to get caught out. This is a shorter race, so we've got to be in and out quicker, whether that be for a profit or a loss. Hopefully we can get our money through at a safe time. Watching the market. Don't like the look of this so far. Would have liked to have gone in at fours, but it wasn't suitable. Maybe this runner here looks a little bit better, but we've got to be careful. And if it doesn't go right, we just get it out. And if that means we don't make any money, taking that out straight away there, because the market isn't doing what
in
I want.
Inside,
now watch the race
Liberty,
timer.
They now head into the home straight. We're just over half a mile left to go.
Is it safe to go through? I don't think so.
Advantage from Nordala in second place. Then right up against the rail, Knight of Luxury. Out wider at Liberty. He's done plenty in the first part of this race under Harry Davis, alongside Wootton's Son.
I think we can get a safe six through here very quickly. But if I've got it wrong, we close off.
Three furlongs. Already gone.
Come on.
The lead from Nordala now being pushed along.
Out. Out wider
at Liberty. Right up against the rail,
and that's
Knight
it.
Of Luxury. Wootton's Son.
That's it. We're protecting the bank. We're not going to take any further risk. I'm just going to try and make sure I am closed off for over £3. You can see this horse may go on to win. It may not. It may do. But I don't want to be involved in a lottery. I want to be a successful trader by picking the right races and the right times to trade. It's the only way to do it. And you can see how early I was out in that race. There was no reason to be in any longer. I could have been greedy and gone for an extra trade to make more money, but in the long
market run, suspended.
I would have actually made more money on a later trade, possibly even two. I might have got it up to about 7-8 quid. But the fact of the matter is, over the long run, I would lose money, and it's just not worth it. It's too dangerous. Just get your trades through on the right races and get your timing right at the right time. And avoid them dangerous times where you're likely to lose money if you want to be profitable.
So you'll jump safe.
Okay, so we've got a race here. It's 3:05 at Fakenham. It's on a Tuesday afternoon, but it's Tuesday the 3rd of May 2022. So it's the day after the May bank holiday, essentially. It's going to be a bit like a Monday today, if that makes sense. You know, everyone's just back at work, probably even worse because, you know, people are back at work and so on, and after having a little bit of an extended weekend. Now, this race, I wouldn't normally bother with, but I am looking at it because I'm not doing anything else at the moment, so I might as well have a glance and just put my head in and see what's going on. And the reason I wouldn't is because, essentially, if you look at the prices of the horses, they're all too big for me to trade because my liability is going to be too huge. And then we've got basically two favourites that are not much more above even money. And if one of them was something was to happen to one of them, the other one's price is going to come crashing in to massively odds on, and we could get caught out. And we're going to need to use quite a large stake, you know, with not much time for the market to move to put us in trouble. I mean, yeah, granted, if I use a £50 stake here, I might use a £50 liability at fours, but what you've got to consider at 4.0, the market has to move a long way before I actually lose 25 quid, actually, right the way down to evens, where here it doesn't have to move so far. So it's like, you know, do I want to get involved? Do I not? So we're just going to have a look at it, but this is probably one that you should, unless you've got a pre-planned strategy, because there's something you fancy laying low or dobbing or something like that, or maybe a back to lay or something like that. These are probably the markets that you don't really want to trade, if that makes sense. They can be pretty good pre-race, because if one comes in, then the other one has to go out, sort of thing, so you can predict movements quite often on certain runners. But I'm just spectating this one. If I see an opportunity, I'll put some money through, but the likelihood is I probably won't. But this is an important thing to learn, because when you're trading, right, everyone wants to make money, yeah? But what you should be concentrating on is not losing money. Any fool can make money on Betfair, right? Any fool will make money on Betfair. Even if you just put random trading, you will make money on Betfair. But you will also lose money. And so cutting out your losses is a really important part of the game. Cutting out your losses, the boring part of trading, is the bit that actually makes you profitable. So sitting on your hands and doing nothing, yeah, it's pretty boring. Makes for a boring video for me, blah, blah, blah. But it's really important if you want to progress on. You have to understand this. You have to understand, like, you have to wait for your opportunities, and this isn't really one of them. Okay, so this is an Irish race. In terms of distance, it suits my strategy, but in terms of liquidity that's been matched pre-race, it doesn't. So it's only ticked one of the two boxes so far. If we are going to trade this, we need to make sure that the money in play is enough and coming in quick enough, moving around enough for us to get matched both sides of the book. Now, you can see at the moment, there's lots of gaps between the money coming in. Look, if you see the piles of money, look, gap, gap, gap. So if I was to go in there, I might not get matched quick enough. And if we're looking at the amount of money changing hands, it may not be quick enough. Now, there may be an opportunity this race for me to make some money, but because it's Irish and the liquidity is lower, it also means that the market could move a lot quicker against me. So it's really important that if I do trade this, which at this stage I may not, I need to be in and out earlier on in the race safely. And if it does go wrong, I need to take the loss extremely quickly. Let's have a little look.
De Blanc, Russian Diamond and Boston Brahman. Continuing to the top end of the bag.
So you can see this has been moving up and down quite a lot just now, but it's stalled again, and you can see that gaps in the market. Was a £230 bet, but these are all minuscule bets in comparison.
Russian Diamond just fourth from Boston.
So I'm not keen to get in just yet. And because it's an Irish race, we need to be out earlier. I need to be out by this line, really, because otherwise I could get myself in a lot of trouble as the market moves, especially if a horse hits straight towards the front early on and I happen to be laying it. So, at this stage, I don't actually know if I'm going to trade it or not. This is how you need to be thinking. Don't put a trade in for the sake of it. This is suicide right now. So, a waiting game now.
Going to the fifth flight, which is four from the finish. Supreme Jet.
Just still waiting.
Running the rail is playing.
I am tempted to get it at threes because it's a good price. At the back of the field. Not too big a stake. I'm only using a £50 bank anyway, but you can see I've only put 15 in. I see that money coming in, so I've cancelled it using the XP. I'm not going to take the risk. See, I'd be waiting around six ticks. I'd have been up here where that money is there at 335, and I'd have been in too long.
Supreme Jet. By less than a leg to Hope de Blanc, who's picked second spot off of.
Gonna have another look.
Indian, and then Boston.
But don't forget what I said about the timing. It's really important.
Supreme Jet yet to be headed over by length and a half to Hope de Blanc. In third is Plains Indian.
Now, if we don't get matched, it doesn't matter.
Diamond and Boston Brahman. Less than five furlongs to go. They're heading for the second lap.
We've got five furlongs.
Supreme Jet from Plains Indian Hope de Blanc, poised and behind.
So I need matching very quickly now.
The outside is Boston Brahman as they approach the last flight down the back.
You can see we're approaching that red zone.
Sucker.
That's the sound warning.
Nudged along behind them.
Too risky to go in. Yeah, it looks like we've made money. I don't know, I see it flicked down to 3-4, but we might have made money then, we might not have done, but it's just not worth it now. If you want to take a gamble, get involved now. If you don't and you want to be a professional trader, hang on to your money.
has improved on the outside of Shady Operator and then Bold Emperor and Peregrine Run. Optical Confusion next with the Diamond.
Get that money out.
Where you're thinking as they head to the third.
Plenty of time in this race, so I'm not panicking. This is that we're in the red. Something like that, 85 there. So I'm just going to jump in front of it. Gold,
joined by Charlie
Stone. Get that money out.
Moving on a couple of lengths in front of Rock
for
Road.
A profit. There you go.
Platinum is starting to struggle at the back. Is getting a.
Got to be really careful with this Irish racing. You really do.
Far side coming across to fences 8 and 9 before embarking on their final circuit. Change of leader. Charlie Stout goes on by 2.5 lengths to Jackson's Gold and Rock Road. Followed by Bold Emperor and Shady Operator and Peregrine Run next with Optical Confusion. I like the way you're thinking and the Data Man fully charged next. On the inside, improving. A fraction is the Dabbler as they straighten for the fence. That'll be the last next time in the McHale Mayo National. Charlie Stout rejoined by Jackson's Gold. 2 lengths off them and third is Rock Road. Break of 3 lengths to Bold Emperor and then Shady Operator and Peregrine Run the rail. I like the way you're thinking and Optical Confusion and the Data Man and Max Flamingo and the Dabbler. Champagne Platinum.
Now we've got plenty of time this yet, but we need that money out soon.
The final couple, Revlon Pleasure and
Machuca, going
to the fence, taking them out on their final circuit. This is 6 from home, landing together Charlie Stout and Jackson's Gold. 2 in front of Rock Road, then Bold Emperor, who's taking closer orders, moved into 4th. Break of 2.5 Peregrine Run.
Then we ain't got a lot of time left to get this out. We don't want to be involved in the business then, don't forget.
Confusion. Max Flamingo next with Champagne Platinum and the Dabbler.
So we need this out pretty soon.
Climb along the side of the track to the.
Come on, nearly there. Nearly there, go on. And the rest. And the rest. And the rest. And that's it, job done.
Of Jackson's Gold. Bold Emperor after them and third and.
Now, unless you're a seasoned trader, I certainly do not recommend you trade any Irish racing whatsoever. But that's it. You see, there's a long way in this race to go. You can see we're out early on the race time.
I'm out of here, man.
You've got to be, because it's just too dangerous. And if you don't want to blow your bank, best off you don't trade Irish racing at all. But if you are stupid like me, then make sure you're out really, really early. Because if you're not, you're going to get in trouble. If you put a trade in now and that price goes against you, as you're hitting towards that last 20% of the race, you're going to blow your bank, and you've got to protect your money all the time. So I'm quite happy with £3.18. That would do me.
Is Ooh La La in a dark blue jacket, followed by Poster Child in the red on the inside, and the yellow of Firewater in the back marker in the dark green is Clayton Hall with the lighter green sleeves as they continue their run down the back front. Straight. Joe Mason leads by a length from the tail to giving chase Thomas Cranmer. Monticello now nudged along. He starts to drop back as he's about to be passed by Charlie Arthur on the outside.
I'm out of here, man.
The headway up, Charlie Arthur turning for home. So Whitwell now ridden along. Charlie Arthur, can he continue that move on the outside? He's moving very well for William Carver. Charlie Arthur here, and he's come to get a view of the front now. So Charlie Arthur
has
swept to the front. He's going great guns, Charlie Arthur. He opens up now. Kuzak is getting
pieces
into second place. And then comes Thomas Cranmer as Whitwell backs out of it. The leader is Charlie Arthur.
And we're done.
He's got a furlong to last.
He's by two
he is
done.
Poster Child is staying on late in the day.
It's come on, Kuzak, come on
in. Front, can he see it out? Kuzak going hard in the center. Poster Child out wider. Charlie Arthur is all out, but he'll hold on. Charlie Arthur,
damn
wins.
It. Tight second. Could have got an extra pound.
Market suspended.
Ahead of Kuzak, 150. And they were clear.
But you know, other than closing off, you want to be out quick. Protect your bank. You see, we did that. That horse could have come back and won.
Breaks his maiden tag on the turf. He's now
but we was out. We was out well before that danger zone. So the only thing I had left in play after that was a little bit of hedging. So I did try to close off for a bit more. As the price went out, I kind of accepted I was going to get £7. It started to come back in. Did try to close off for a bit more. But you can see as it came back in, that it traded in very low right at the end there. Shame we didn't get the £8, but, you know, it's only £1 in it. I mean, they all add up, granted, but that is just a little bit of extra hedging. That's all. Anyway, best of luck in the market. Hope that helps.
Local Rotondo's followed by Colin Wayne and the Peddler. Racing inside the final mile and a half. The leader is Umpot Tator.
So, you've got to protect the bank. You've got to crack the Irish race.
spotted colours on the outside of Art of Silence. And then
so if we can get a few ticks of it, great. But more importantly, we've got to watch next our bank. Commander. So I'm sitting outside the price because they're quite buttoned up. Wayne, so it's only if a big bet comes in, picks us up and moves back out again.
First time.
At this stage, we're looking at.
Out in front is Ampot Tator, leading Art of Silence. That's a queen. Followed by Miss Vivacious, Rocco Ray next with Finn the Magician and Big Job as they straighten to the furlong point. Ampot Tator
dropping down 4-0 now.
Extending the advantage all the while over Art of Silence, Miss Vivacious, tracked by Vatsa Queen. Next on the outside, Rocco Ray with Finn the Magician. And then Big Job and Western Commander, Loco Rotondo. With the final couple, Cullen Wayne. And the peddler, Ampot Tator, is proving a handful for Daniel Hyde in front.
Is we didn't get much there, would have been out.
Run off the track, Ampot Tator.
Like that.
And has now moved to the outer rail and has unshipped Daniel Hyde. As that saddle has gone right around the gelding. Daniel Hyde is sitting up. So it's all changed now with Vatsa Queen.
Now, if we only make 81p in this race, then so be it. We're not going to get in fully up now to the danger. We'll sort of run us up here. You can see it's turned into a pretty much, according to the market, a free and a bit horse race, I would call it.
Come out of here, man.
Western Commander, as they reach the Mount of the Hill, struggling and dropping right out of contention is Big Job. Art of Silence, Miss Vivacious, Vatsa Queen, the three in a line, just over the length in front of Rocco Ray, and then Finn the Magician.
And we want to see our money getting matched pretty soon, otherwise we're going to have to lower the price. We don't want to take risks.
After them is the peddler.
I'm out of here, man.
4 furlongs to go. And it's tight for the lead. Vatsa Queen, Art of Silence, Miss Vivacious to their inside, followed by Rocco Ray and Finn the Magician, improving as the peddler and then Loco Rotondo. Western Commander and Cullen Wayne racing past the three, about to turn out of the bag. Art of Silence, Vatsa Queen, Miss Vivacious the rail. These three.
That's far too dangerous to be in now. So if we can close off
the red and white and then Loco Rotondo, push as much as possible. Finn the Magician and then the peddler and Western Commander. Racing past the
let's
two.
See if I can guarantee 285.
To pick it up from Art of Silence, then Miss Vivacious. Loco Rotondo with a good-looking run in between horses, then Rocco Ray, Finn the Magician.
And that's it. Now, if Rocco Ray comes back and wins it now, I don't really care. Vowsa Cream, don't look like it is. Who knows? Who knows at this stage? But you've got to be really careful and protect your bank all the time. You do not want to be involved in markets when they go like this, especially Irish.
Market suspended.
And there you go. So what was the price on that? You can see that was a big price, 60-odd. I reckon that was where it traded pre-race. That's where most of the money was. Look. So, you know, it just goes to show any horse can win. Doesn't matter if it's a short-priced favourite. They can get turned over. Just be very careful. Get your money in there nice and safely. Protect your bank at all times. If it means only taking a small profit, then only take a small profit. Just make sure you get it safely. It means taking a small loss, take a small loss. But don't stay in too long and have huge losses, because a small loss you'll make back in a couple of races, most likely. A big loss might take you like days, weeks to make back if it's huge, especially if you go on a chase and do stupid things. So don't do it. Protect your bank. Don't have fun trading. Have fun spending the money that you made later on. Work for a nice meal with the money you haven't made. Work hard. Treat it as a business when you're trading.
Introducing Geeks Toy Trading Software, the fastest, most customizable, and most popular software for betting and trading on Betfair and BetDaq. Designed by professional traders for you. Key features include unlimited desktop settings and the ability to create custom profiles to suit every user's needs. Unbeatable speed, real-time prices, and one-click betting. Unique management of multiple markets. You can bet or trade on multiple sporting events simultaneously. Support for 8 languages. Context-driven help on every window. Dutching and bookmaking, training mode, advanced charting, enhanced navigation, support for Betfair coupons, stop loss and more. Geeks Toy, possibly the best Betfair and BetDAC trading software in the world.